Seeing him lying on the floor helpless, where I can't do nothing about it, and he was supposed to be a member of my gang, right? But that was something like, I don't know, it was like just an eye-opener to me. And ever since that, I never gang-banged again. It was a rainy day, it seemed, we were just talking about going to get some pizza to eat, right? And we were gang-bangers, okay? And then we just went over there. Once I got out the car, because I wanted to get out the car, something just told me get out the car. Soon as I closed the door, I heard the gunshots and I started running, okay? And then after everything finished, that's when we found out Alex was dead. He was right there in the corner and we just seen him right there. And it wasn't worth it just for him to get killed because he just started gangbanging. He didn't really know what it was about.
And he was a 16-year-old kid?
16-year-old high school kid. All he was about was dancing. He was just enjoyed dancing and enjoyed...
He just wanted to make new friends,
you know,
or something,
have
right?
friends, right. Okay, and all of a sudden, okay. He wanted to hang out with a bunch of people, you know, to be cool and get into a gang, you know, be a tough little kid, be recognized from everybody else. That's what happened. Then all of a sudden, you know, there comes the guys. They start shooting at us. We all run. All of a sudden, one of the guys, the police officers, was right there. They were right there. Right there. And did the police officers do anything? They told us, get out of the way. Don't move. They were going like that to us. And we told them, there's some guys right there, you know, shooting at these guys. And there was a guy right there on the floor, and they were hiding. Right there in the train station, a half a block away. And that's the truth, bro.
I don't gangbang no more. I like the way I am now, okay? But I could still hold my own if I have to. But it wouldn't really matter to me.
It ain't no good. It ain't no good because when you're wrapped up in it and you're stuck in it, that's the kind of life you have to lead.